Now, write a program to multiply any 2 3 by 3 matrix or any n by n matrix. So, how to multiply? For multiplication, I'll give you an idea. If I have two matrices, in multiplication of matrix, I have 1, 2, 5, 1, 2, 1, 0, 1. First, we take the first row and first column. That is 0 row and 0 column. Okay. We multiply 1 with 2, 1 into 2, plus 2 into 0, plus 2 into 0. This has to be placed here. Then first row and first column is complete. Then we multiply this row with this column. That is 1 into 1 plus 2 into 1. We have to place it here. Again, this row is completed. Now we go to the second row. 5 into 2 plus 1 into 0 to be placed here. And now 5 into 1 plus 1 into 1 will be placed here. This is how the multiplication goes. So we ought to have one more thing, that the column of this, say, if I say A into B, this is the A into B is the dimension or order, and we say this is C into D. So if we want to multiply it, this B has to be equal to C. The column of first row has to be equal to the row of the second matrix. This has to be made very clear. Now these two are equal, so we'll have a variable K. We'll introduce a variable, that is. So we'll first of all, we'll make three matrices, matrix 1, matrix 2, matrix 3. In the first one will enter the values, ampersand mat 1 ij. Then we'll enter the second matrix. So we are taking it ampersand mat 2. Now you can just show the matrix first and second. Now here comes the actual scenario. As I said, we have to multiply the first row with the first column. So when we multiply this element with this, actually there are three, so let us take this example. This with this into plus this into this plus this into this. So we have taken a sum equal to 0. We are doing exactly the same stuff. We are adding it, but what we are doing here is mat ik is multiplied by mat kj. So I is the row, k is the column, and k is what we just told you, k is that value which remains to be constant for both the rows and columns or both the matrix. So this will not change. That is why we want the column of the first matrix has to be equal to the row of the second matrix. So mat ik into mat 2 kj, this is the whole concept here. You just have to understand this. Okay, then just add them sum, and finally just save this sum into mat ij, this particular value, and again go back and say sum equal to 0. So every time you do, you will get a sum for the next one, this by this. So you can just put it, and that will be placed in the third matrix, and now you can just show that third matrix.